Instagram.
Well, I went with my dad, who's 92 now. I mean, he wasn't 92 then, but he really, really wanted to see it. And I mean, moving through the labyrinth of New York with my dad and getting to see it, we just stood because it wasn't completed. It was just a big, big hole in the ground. But people had festooned that big hole in the ground with messages of hope and love. And, you know, your eyes are pouring with tears and you're looking at this vast devastation, and but you're reading, looking at piles of flowers and candles and people's messages and prayers for their children that they lost or husbands. And it was a powerful experience that I will never forget, and I don't think anybody that ever goes there will ever forget, and I don't think anybody ever should. We should always remember.
We saw it about a year after, and in 2012, and my boys were with us at the time.
Right.
And like you said, it's hard to, it's kind of like when you saw it happen the first time, you don't know what to think when you're when you're standing there looking at this big gaping hole, and like you said, the fence is stuffed, you know, festooned with all these messages and pictures, and it was, I don't know how you describe it, it's almost like going to church, because it was sacred.
It's an alternate type of experience.
Yeah.
We live our lives out in the open, and we're free.
Did you see
Americans,
people that you thought were not really affected? These days, I guess, you know, because of technology, because we see everything so quickly, you know, as soon as it happens on television and we see it over and over and over, maybe we're desensitized to the seriousness of it. But I know when we were there, I'm a very emotional person anyway, but you see some people who are, it's a tourist attraction. I'm being very judgmental here because, you know, they may have been there a while and had already done their respectful grieving or whatever, but I remember thinking, I don't think they get it. I don't think they understand what this big giant hole is. Of course, now it's a big giant building and a memorial. But, that was when the rubble was still piled up in places that probably contained people.
Mm-hmm.
Right? And it's, you know, it was surreal,
I through a series of events that happened here in Ellijay, I get to meet one of the a woman who actually ran a crane in New York that removed the rubble, and she shared with me and with everybody the great things that they did to honor the rubble. As you speak of it, so you know that's, it is a sacred
God
place.
Bless them.
Yeah.
God bless them.
Yeah, it is. All right, right now we're going to go to the 9/11 tribute. Then when we come back, Lucy's going to read a poem for the class of 2017.
Right. From Noah.
From Noah. So we'll be back in just a couple of minutes, y'all. Just sit back, reflect.